is a journey from Dadyals to Leaside Road, where the BMW apparently lost its wheel. We've just passed Stonebridge on the left, and we're now just passing Dadyals on the right. That was a shop that was lit up. We're now passing Arnos station, and we're still continuing on Bowes Road. We're now at the junction of the A406 Bowes Road. There's a camera just up on the left. Now, anyone would have thought that that camera would have caught the car. We're now continuing along the A406 Bowes Road. This is the junction of Bowes Road and Brownlow Road, where the BMW was caught by a TFL ANPR camera. Past the speed camera, see the road marking. This is a junction of Bowes Road and Greens Lane, where there is another TFL camera that could have caught the car. Thank you. on this underpass, you've got cameras on this left-hand wall. You've got three of them. You've also got one outside as you're going down, and also as you enter the tunnel, there's one hanging down. And as you leave the tunnel, there's another one hanging down on the right-hand side on the, from the roof. And also, as you come out, you've got another camera that is up quite high. Now leaving the A406 and coming up to Montague Road. As we come up to this junction, there's a camera on the left. It was just here where the car was apparently caught speeding up behind the lorry at 3:07 a.m. You've got this bend, which is a sharp bend, and it continues for a little while. And at 40 miles an hour, this is where he would have sped past, but at 40 miles an hour, that seemed well fast enough. Quite fast to take that bend, let alone 70 miles an hour or 100 miles an hour. Now this is a junction, Glover Drive, Tesco's, where apparently the BMW sped past at breakneck speed, which they reckon is up to 100 miles an hour. One of their witnesses said that the wheel was hanging off, another one said it was missing. The back wheel was really dented, which we saw, but the front wheel had no dent in. Apparently, this hit the curb at full force, yet it was an alloy wheel and wasn't dented at all. Now, he's come on three wheels, apparently, according to the police, along here, past Sedge Road, so there's one central reservation there he had to get past on three wheels. Second central reservation on three wheels. Now, bearing in mind the car will be pulling to the right all the time, he's ended up past his central reservation in the opposite side of the road, where the car came to a standstill opposite the alleyway on the left. On the left here is where the jacket was found in the field. This is where all the police were and the helicopter was, and they were doing the dog search and everything that night. Now, as we come up here, there's a central reservation just here. We're turning left because that is where the lock is. But one of the witnesses turned on and said that there was another accident, very, very similar, at that location. Not the location down at the other end at the east side road. And you can see how dark it is here. This is where the lock and the car park and everything is, which is where he would have had to come to get into the river that he was found in. And this was done tonight.